Hi guys, I'm Brittany. I'm with the Florida Fish and Wildlife Research Institute in the Fisheries Independent Monitoring section. I've been working here for 8 years now.
I'm Eric Weather. I've been here for almost 15 years doing this type of work.
I'm Alex. I'm kind of the new guy. I've been here for about 3 years.
So today we're out on one of our inshore trips where we conduct our monthly sampling. It takes a lot of planning and prepping before the trip even goes out. And this morning we met really early and we loaded up our gear and we headed out to our first site.
Yeah, at our first site today, we pulled a 600-foot seine net.
All right, so we're pulling the net in here along the shore, trying to stay as close as we can, flushing any fish out from the trees that might get stuck in there.
We pull these large seine nets along the shoreline. A lot of the shorelines here in Florida are real shallow. This is great fish habitat. Lush seagrass beds, mangrove shoreline habitat. This is gonna be a good spot to take a sample. And all of this work is part of our long-term monitoring program. So we want to keep track of the fish populations throughout the bay, throughout all the estuaries in Florida through time.
So here's a great example of something we might catch in this big net right here. Snook is a really popular sport fish here in Tampa Bay. We're looking for these big fish, but we also catch some of these smaller fish as well.
But pinfish are a great indicator species to see how the entire population is doing. A lot of the major sport fish fisheries in Florida depend on pinfish populations to be healthy.
And after we pulled the 600-foot seine, we pulled our smaller seine, which is 70 feet.
So it's important for us to not only keep track of the large fish that are swimming around the bay here, but we also want to see when the juveniles come into the bay and they settle out. That's what gives us some power to predict populations in the future.
The smaller seine that we use has a lot finer mesh, so then we catch smaller species. We also catch juvenile sport fish in that net.
Here are some gray snapper. You can see at their different life stages, their colorations change pretty drastically.
So this is a chained pipefish. We get guys that look really similar to these, but these ones have kind of like a distinct chain pattern on the side.
This one's called the Olisaurus, also called a leather jacket. It's got spines that can actually feel like a bee sting, so you gotta be careful.
And that seine, we were able to pull along shorelines, but we can also pull them in the bay, like on a grass flat or on a sandbar, and that allows us to sample different environments using the same gear type.
So this is a blue crab. While we come out here and sample fish, there's also select invertebrates that are commercially important that we care about as well. This one's a fairly large male. We'll count these and measure them just like we would for fish. Let them go.
And now that we've collected all of this data, we are not finished with it. We have a lot of things that we need to do with it.
Most of our data goes to a long-term monitoring so we can see how individual species are tracking through time and keep our finger on the pulse of those populations. Another thing we can do is look at the whole entire fish community and see how that changes in response to different environmental disturbances such as red tide or a cold kill. And we can not only see how the fish population was prior to the disturbance, but also during, and then how it recovers after.
So today was actually a really beautiful day for us to come out sampling, but some days we're not as lucky.
I remember pulling a net where we caught 600 snook in one net, and we had to count and measure all those. I think it took us 4 hours. We were real careful to keep them all alive and let them go.
Yeah, we had one a couple months ago, and I think we caught 200 stingrays.
Oh,
so
man.
We had to, you know, get them all out of the boat and count and measure some. So
any injuries?
No, none, luckily.
So the FIM program, a lot of our monitoring is based on a stratified random sampling design, and there's a lot of power in that particular statistical setup because we go out and we use different gear types, and for those different gear types, we can sample different habitats. That allows you to look at the data, analyze it, but also amplify the data and get a bigger picture of what's going around in the bay, because it's not all uniform. There's a lot of different habitat types that fish use differently. And since we sample those different habitats, we can get a really broad picture of what's going on with fisheries.